Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Path, Tome 2, The Epiphany, which I bought here in the Ark Library in the Nobles' Quarter. Tome 2, The Epiphany, Verse 9. Before us there was chaos, and after us chaos will remain. Since man has a weak spirit and a spoiled heart, it is only under divine guidance that he shall blossom. Do not grieve over bowing your heads to us. Fools mistake our might with tyranny, even as sages recognize our deepest desire, to shoulder the burden of man's foolishness and to protect humanity. Verse 10. Yet not everyone realized the Lightborn's divinity, and so it happened that a great man stepped forward. His name was Melros. Verse 11. You claim to be gods, he shouted at the Lightborns with a firm voice. The last god who reigned over us brought us nothing but harm and destruction. You claim that your wish is to protect us, but how can we trust you? Verse 12. One of the figures drifted down towards Melros. Still endowed with light, its body narrowed to become even smaller than the man in front of it. It was the Lightborn Erlanda. Verse 13. Your doubts bespeak wisdom, O Melros. And yes, a Satyron was deluded and wicked, but it came from ignorance. Even though he was aware of his divinity, his origin was as much a mystery to him as it was to us. It was this uncertainty which devastated his heart. Verse 14. We are of a different kind. We are the messengers of peace. Follow us, and this world shall blossom. Our reign will last eternally, since we are not of flesh and blood as you are. We, O Melros, are the Lightborn. Verse 15. And Melros acknowledged the divinity of the figure standing in front of him. Filled with awe and understanding, he fell to his knees and begged their pardon. Verse 16. So began the hegemony of the Lightborn, and it was righteous. For the Lightborn were true gods, free of human vices, free of a Satyron's madness. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, The Path, Tome 2, The Epiphany.